So I took up refereeing through a really good friend of mine, so I've probably got a lot to be thankful to her for. Yeah, so took it up 11 years ago with never the intention of ever refereeing again. I had a referee to qualify, so I did the 5 games and just got the bug, and it just went from there, really. My key goal in refereeing, I'm not one of these referees who looks too far in the future, so I always focus on the next game. I always focus on going to the next game, going out there, doing my best and seeing what happens. So, you know, short term, I think we'll look to the end of the season. You know, it's nearly upon us. We'd love to be in a position to be considered for promotion to the Football League. So I guess when we're looking at short term goals, yeah, we'll go with that, getting to the end of May and seeing what that brings. I think it's important that we do identify that the men's game and the women's game are different. You know, the men's is that bit faster, but I would argue that the women are more skillful. But yeah, there's also a difference in personalities. You know, the women are, sometimes the women ask questions all the time because they're more inquisitive about what's happened and why you've given a decision. Whereas the men might ask a question and then 2 minutes later they'll forget what even they're asking. And I think that's just different personalities. Both challenge you very differently, but both give you essential skills to help me, well, certainly help me develop as a referee. My fitness schedule is probably the bit that takes up most of my time. So training every day, doing different sessions, whether that be high intensity, strength work, speed work, agility. My favourite day of the week is rest day, which I don't get enough of them of. But yeah, it's demanding the fitness, but it has to be because we as referees need to be the fittest people on the field to play. So yeah, I quite enjoy doing fitness, so it's not too bad for me. But yeah, sometimes on a Monday morning when you get up and you try the session, I'm not gonna lie, I sometimes like rolling my eyes. But yeah, it's gotta be done, variation each day, but yeah, I quite enjoy it. I think when anybody's going to try anything new, I think there's always a bit apprehensive, or they're always a bit apprehensive, they're always a little bit nervous, and I think that's normal. Every game I go out there, you know, I get a bit nervous. I think a lot of people focus on refereeing as you go out there and you get 90 minutes of the game, and that is just, certainly has not been the case for me, and I know it hasn't been the case for a lot of referees. So I think sometimes the thought of doing something is always worse than actually doing it. So if you've got an ambition to be a referee, get in touch with the County FA, come and do the course, and then we can look at giving you games where they're run in a safe environment. So we've got academies, a lot of the clubs follow the Respect programme now. So, you know, the abuse that people talk about, you know, it is few and far between. So I would definitely say if you've got an ambition to do it, then come along and give it a try. Yeah, I played football when I was younger, so when I was very young, and then picked it up again when I was 18. I just played at local level, you know, that the opportunities weren't really there for me when I was younger, but I think even if there had been, I don't think I would have chose a route in playing as a career. Definitely being a referee gives me a bigger window to continue, so I'm 37 now and I'm still going strong, so if I'd been a footballer, I'm not sure I still would have been going as strong. So yeah, I did play, but local level, just something to do on a weekend, help me mates and keep fit, really. Men's or women's? I prefer them both because they both challenge me in different ways. You know, they're both different experiences. I love going along to a National League game on a Saturday, but then we get the opportunity to go to some of the biggest stadiums in England on a Sunday and referee the women's. So, you know, I couldn't choose between the two. I love them both equally as much. Favourite holiday destination? Okay, well, I'm not really too keen on flying. So if I'm in the air, I like to be in the air quite short. So I'm going to go for Ibiza. Not the party side of Ibiza. Ibiza to go there and chill for 4 days and relax in the sun. Yeah, I would definitely say that. So I was fortunate enough a few years ago to do a mini tournament in Bosnia. So we spent nine days there. I think when the appointment comes through, it's never a place I I've ever thought, oh, I really want to go. But the history around Bosnia, and you know, obviously it's very recent since they had the war there, and just to go there and learn about their culture was absolutely amazing. So yeah, I'm going to say Bosnia just for the whole history around the country.